the January 2019 CSEC Mathematics paper, question 1A, part 1. Evaluate 3.8 times 10 squared plus 1.7 times 10 cubed, giving your answer in standard form. Now, before we start, remember, you must attempt all the questions first before you actually watch these past paper solutions. Okay? Now, let's see what's happening here. You have 3.8 times 10 squared, first of all. 10 squared is 100. So this is the same as 3.8 times 100. And the shortcut when multiplying 3.8 times 100 is to move the point two places to the right. It's like moving the numbers two places to the left, right? So you have 380. Two places. Then you have plus 1.7 times 10 cubed. Now it's the same as 1.7 times what is 10 cubed? It's 1,000. And you notice 10 squared has 1 and 2 zeros, 10 cubed has 1 and 3 zeros. In the same way, 10 to the 4th has 1 and 4 zeros, 10 to the 5th has 1 and 5 zeros. Alright, you'll notice that pattern. So, this is 1,700. So, you have 1,700 plus 380. 0 plus 0 is 0, 8 plus 0 is 8, 7 plus 3 is 10. So, bring down the 0, carry 1. 1 and 1 is 2, so it's 2,080. Then they say you should give your answer in standard form. So what is 2,080 in standard form? Well, in standard form, you have the first non-zero digit. When you look from left to right, the first digit that you see that is not zero, you put that down, then the point, and the other digits after it, times 10 to a certain power. What must you multiply 2.08 by for it to become 2,080? It's by 1,000, of course. So you will multiply by 1,000. Let's call this times 1,000. But this is the same as 2.08. You don't really need to have the other digit here, but you can put it. Times 10 to the 3. Alright? So, you have 2.08 multiplied by 10 to the power of 3. And that's the answer for this part. So, I have 2.080. I keep the extra zero there just as an indication of what the number would have been like before. Alright? But it's the same thing as 2.08 times 10 to the power of 3. So remember, standard form, as you look from left to right, the first zero digit that you see that is not zero, that's what you put down, then the point. Because somebody could have written 0.2080, you know. It's the same 2.080 because you didn't need this zero. Even if they had a string of zeros before it, you don't need all these zeros. They're not significant. The first number that is significant, the first non-zero digit as you look from left to right, is the 2. So you put 2 there, the point, and the other digits times 10 to the power.